across. Right when I push it across, I'm going to lay down his arm here to trap him. Here. Okay? So, in the beginning here, I pick a wrist. I'm going to shove it down, and immediately I'm going to lay down on it. You see how his arm's across? I'm going to reach, and I'm going to reach under his neck, and I'm going to grab his wrist. And here. Okay, so now he's in this position. Here. Okay, which is a really good position to strike from. Okay? Here. Uncomfortable. I'm going to bring my outside knee closer to his head, and my inside leg, my heel's going to go to his chest. Here. So now I'm in this position. And this is a really good position to strike from. Okay? And now I'm going to take his back. I have two options. I can either grab underneath his elbow here, or I can grab underneath his tricep here. Okay? So this time I'm going to grab underneath his elbow. Okay? I'm in this position. Now the way I'm going to sit back is I'm going to like go up, I'm going to stand up. Like if I'm going to take off. Like if I'm going to do this and take off. Okay? So when I get the angle to here, this leg is going to come up probably around this area above his head. And I'm going to use that leg to pivot off, and I'm going to pull him on top of me, okay, into the side. So here, this leg is going to come up, and I'm going to tip back, and I'm going to pull him up on top of me here, okay? Kind of like a spooning type of position. So I still have wrist control here, okay? This arm, if it's not underhooked, I'm going to shoot to get the underhook, because I want better control of him in this position. This arm's going to shoot underneath to get the underhook, okay? I can go to shoot to put my hooks in, and I want better control here. Now I can let go of his wrist, and I can start working for my choke, because I have good control here. I got my over-under here. Okay? So from the beginning, I'm in the mount position. He's in a good defense, you know, home low. I grab a wrist, shove it to the mat, cover with my body. Okay? Post. Remember your bridges. I have a really stable position here, because at this point, if he starts to buck, okay, I can still have his arm trapped, and I'm still able to keep my position. So I'm here, I block his arm, I reach underneath his head, and I grab his wrist. My outside knee comes up towards his head, this inside leg comes up, and my heel to his chest to here. I can strike if I'm doing MMA, okay? This hand goes underneath his tricep, so I either grab his elbow, or I grab his tricep. Now I'm going to go like if I'm going to run. I'm going to bring that leg up on the top of his head, and I'm going to pull him back underneath me. When I pull him back underneath me, my right arm is immediately going to shoot and get the underhook. So I'm here, pull back, and I got the underhook here. Okay? I put my hooks in, I let go of this wrist, and I go to here, or I go to over-under, and I start working for my choke, whatever technique someone start working. Okay? Remember, when you get in this position, you're still going to have to get this hook, okay? So when I land here, I have his wrist. When I land here, I already have this hook in, okay? I have to get this hook in here, and then I can go to here. I can control my position. If I land here, let's say I land too high, I can adjust, okay? Let's say I land right about here. I can use this underhook, and I can pull myself down. I can use this leg, plant it on the mat, and I can shoot my body down, and I can adjust right about here. This feels a little bit better, and I can shoot this here, shoot my hook in, and then start working my technique. Okay, one more time, full speed. That's